Greetings one, greetings all. Yes, another video. Normally I don't have that much to talk about, but as of late I've had a lot of tobacco-related stuff arrive. And so I have some subjects to talk about, so I figured I can make some videos. What I'm going to talk about today is Thanchers, aromatic tobaccos from Sri Lanka. Blink 182 Ishi sent me a couple packs. I smoked some of the aromatic. There's aromatic there. I smoked some of this last night. I smoked a bowl of this last night. And I gotta say, it rocked my world. Not in a bad way. I have never had a aromatic tobacco that came anywhere close to the type of tobacco that this is. Most aromatic tobaccos, we all know about aromatic tobaccos, they burn hot, they give you tongue bite, the flavor, the casing flavor only lasts. If you're lucky, if it's a good one, it'll last all the way to the bottom of the bowl, but as it gets toward the bottom of the bowl, the flavor is very muted. In most cases, it's just the first couple of lights that you get flavor, and then it's gone. This stuff is insane. This will ghost a pipe the very first bowl you smoke. The aromatic, again, this blend is called aromatic, like I said in the box opening video, is smells to me just like Wrigley's Big Red chewing gum, that cinnamon smell. Okay, now with the chores. This is a pipe, a basket pipe that I got off of eBay. I really like the shape. I believe it's called a pot shape. It's got a real nice, interesting stem, which is flat, tapered. I like this, and I designated this one for aromatics. Unfortunately, now it's been designated strictly for Thanchers blend, because I smoked a bowl of this aromatic in there last night, and this morning I took a whiff of the pipe and I was like, wow, it ghosted it really bad. Very cinnamon smell. A slight spicy smell to it. When you draw on the pipe without lighting it, you can taste the flavor. I mean, it's very strong taste in your mouth. The bright lights here. But it, like I said, it very much reminds me of cinnamon. And when I smoked it, it even reminded me more of when I was a kid. I wanted to be an outlaw and wanted to be a bad guy. So I couldn't get my hands on cigarettes. So I used to smoke cinnamon sticks. Okay, yeah, you think I'm weird. Here's the proof. Here's a cinnamon stick. This is a big long one. I didn't smoke long ones like this. The ones I smoked were smaller. But these would burn nice and slow. You see, I got an ash on the end of there because I took a little journey down reminiscent trail. These would burn nice and slow, and they give off a smoky flavor. They're hard to light. I usually light them like an incense stick and then let them go out. And they are very good. Problem is this one, they rolled it up funny, so it's got a seam along here. When they're rolled up like a fruit roll-up or a cigarette would be rolled up, then they smoke a lot better. But here, this one's not so good. But the flavor from this is the same strong flavor that's in this Thanchers, so it brought me back. So yeah. So that I enjoyed about it. But anyway, it's very strong, but very good. So I'm going to light it up. Wow! Oh. Very strong flavor. So anyway, I like it. I like it, I like it, I want more of it. Another box opening today. JR Cigars, every now and then has a, when you sign up and get on their mailing list, oh, the room note on this, outstanding. My wife loved it. She says, ooh, that smells really good, kind of like one of those scent candles. Yeah, that'll work. Package here from JR Cigars. JR Cigars, every now and then, will blow out some backlog of cigars that they have for, like, ridiculously cheap prices. 60 cents a stick. Now, I can't even go down to my Tobacco Depot, my cut-rate liquor store that has a humidor, and buy their house brand cigars, a bundle of 20, for that. They always come out to like $2 and something a stick. Oh boy, this is kind of cool. Now, I'm not a big cigar snob or anything like that, so don't get me wrong, I think that's cool. People that are really into those high-end cigars, I think, you know, like Beans 316, man, I get a kick out of watching his videos when he's smoking a $50 cigar. I mean, that is just way cool. And I really have an appreciation for guys that have the financial means to do that, but that's not me. So, the problem is I enjoy cigars. I'm not obsessed with cigars, but I do enjoy cigars. And with this hot weather, as of late, I've been enjoying at least one cigar a day. Usually in the evening, I go sit out on the back porch and smoke a cigar. And JR Cigars is such a huge cigar outlet that they usually end up with cigars that they can't, that aren't selling for whatever reason. They just have such a huge volume of cigars that I think some of the stuff just gets slipped in under the radar and people don't notice it or whatever, or it's not a popular brand like Cuba or Acid or something like that. So nobody targets these cigars. So, see now on the relight, same strong flavor. Love it. Never, the flavor never diminished. Still there. So anyway, JR Cigars ends up with a huge warehouse full of cigars, and they just want to keep the product flowing. They don't want to have a backlog of cigars sitting in a warehouse, so they just want to keep it going. So they'll have like daily specials or weekly specials where you can get a bundle of cigars for an insane cheap price. And what happens is when you get on the mailing list, you'll get mail from them. You'll get an email from them periodically, and it'll say deals of the week or whatever. And you look at them, and what got me the last two times was, bang, 60 cents a stick? 90 cents a stick? A bundle for I got a bundle here. It's a bundle of 25 cigars. $15. Come on. Where are you going to get that? Okay. Now, granted, these aren't, like I said, they're not name brand cigars. But these are 7-inch, these are Churchills, which I like, 7 by 36 ring gauge bundle of 25 for $15. So I pulled the trigger, and I bought two bundles. And then to top it off, for the month of July, they had 99 cent shipping on all orders. Huh. of things. So, here we go.
Villar V. Villar, imported from Nicaragua, 25 handmade cigars. Seven by 36. I grabbed two bundles of them.
I spent less for these two bundles of 25 than I would have spent by going up the block here to my cut rate liquor store and buying a bundle of 21 of their house brand cigars. To do that would cost me $45, $50 for a bundle of 21 generic house brand cigars. I got 50 cigars for less than what I'd pay for 20 up the street. Can't go wrong. So anyway, I'm going to open this up once. I want to take a look at these. I got to get them in the humidor. Although I don't think I have room in my humidor anymore, because I just pulled the trigger a couple of weeks ago on another deal they had where I got a bundle of 21 cigars from Mexico for like $16.
Little smaller diameter than I like, but what the heck.
So yeah, two bundles, $30. I'll be in cigars for a long time. This stuff is still going strong, tasting just as great as ever. It'll taste great right to the bottom of the bowl. I'm going to finish it up, and the next one I'm going to try is that packet of apple that I got from Ishan. That'll be my next video, but I got to say, I'm really impressed with this aromatic. I just love it. It's unlike any aromatic I've ever had, and I got to be honest and say that it's probably pretty close. It's in the top five of aromatic tobaccos I've tried. So, with that, there's that. And I got nothing further for today. So we'll catch all of you on the flip side.